Hello, welcome to MooMooMath, where we upload a new math video every day. In this video, I would like to talk about finding Q1, Q3, and IQR, interquartile range. This would be helpful when you're setting up a box plot or doing a box and whisker, and so you may be a little bit confused in finding these numbers. Step one in finding the Q1, Q3, and eventually the IQR is you'll need to order the numbers from least to greatest. Once they're in order from least to greatest, step two is you need to identify the extremes. Next, you will find the median of the entire data set. Step four is find Q3 or the upper quartile, and this is the median of the upper half of the data. You will only use the data to the right of the original median. Step five is find the Q1 or the lower quartile, and this is the median of the lower half. And finally, you will calculate the IQR or the interquartile range by subtracting the lower quartile from the upper quartile. So let's go ahead and look at an example and walk through these.
Let's go ahead and look at the first data set. And here it is, 19, 25, 16, 20, 34, 7, 31, 12, 30, 22, 29, 16.
Step one is you would go ahead and put them in least to greatest order. And to save time, I have gone ahead and done that. And if you'll notice, we have 7. You can see it. We start at 7, end at 34. Okay. Now we're going to identify the extremes. The extremes would be 7 and 34. And you can see why you need to order them from least to greatest, because it would be just take some of the guesswork out of finding the extremes. Next, you need to find the median of the entire data set. So what I'm going to do, normally I cross these off, but at the same time I'm going to put a mark here, mark there, mark here, mark there, mark here, mark there. And I will continue this until I get the median of 20. So 20 is the median of this data set. Okay. Now, step three is you will find Q3. Now, please notice, since we have an odd number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, we will not include the median of the data set in the Q3. So what I will do is I'm going to go ahead and put a parentheses over top of this, okay? And so that is our Q3. And so now what we need to do is go ahead and find the median of this top set. And I'm going to cross this out, this, this, and this. And the median is 29. And now for Q1, I will do the same, except Q1 is the lower set. And I will mark this off, this one, this, this, and 16 is the median of the lower set, okay? So now for the IQR, I take the median of Q3 minus Q1, so that would be 29 minus 16, which is equal to 13, okay? And then the range of these numbers, if you need to know it, the range will be 34 minus 7, which is 27. Okay, so let's go ahead and answer these questions if we can. What are the extremes? They are 7 and 34. The median of the entire data set we found is 20. The Q3 is the median of this top range, and that is 29. The Q1 is this lower, which was 16. And then the IQR was 29 minus 16, which is equal to 13. Okay, let's work one more set just to see if we get a handle of this. Okay, and I went ahead and placed these numbers to save a little bit of time in increasing order. So the extremes would be 65 and 100, okay? Next, I need to find the median of this set, And I went go ahead and cross these off. Okay. And when I get down to the end, you'll notice that we have two numbers, and that's 80 and 82. So the average of 80 and 82 is 81.5. Okay, that's just the average of 80 and 82. So now, since we do not have an odd number, we're going to go ahead and include 80 and 82 in the set. So next, I'm going to put a bracket around this. That is Q1, and Q3 is here. Okay, so again, what is the median? 81.5. That's the median of the data set. Q3 is I mark these off and I find the median of this top set, and that is 90. Okay, so that would be 90. And Q1 is, again, I check these off, finding the median of this bottom, and that is 70. And then the IQR is 90 minus 70, which equals 20. Okay, so that would be the IQR, 20. Hope that helps you in finding Q1, Q3, and the IQR, interquartile range. Thanks for watching. MooMooMath uploads a new math video every day.